Hello everyone, and now we will begin with our first lecture in our practice questions with 20 different questions in CPIM part 1. Question number 1. Lean principles demand more on coaching and learning from those with experience rather than a management directive. A leader or coach in this environment can be referred to as Master Scheduler, Sensei, Jaiduka, Adam. Here we'll talk about lean management and what is the definition of a leader or coach in this environment. Environment of lean management in Japanese business. So the right answer will be Sensei. Sensei is related to lean management and means teacher or one with experience in Japanese business, which appear after World War II. Question number 2. What is the primary objective of inventory control? Minimize total inventory. Ensure inventory is protected and secure in storage. Minimize inventory stockout. Ensure proper execution of inventory policies. Here we will talk about the primary objective of inventory control, not inventory management. So the right answer will be ensure proper execution of inventory policies. The primary objective of inventory control is very tactical, rather than the inventory management. It's a higher level, strategic level, and included objective of minimizing total inventory and minimizing inventory stock out. Question number 3. Quickly growing work in process inventory is most likely attributable to which of the following? Machining efficiency, an increase in standard hour produced, a bottleneck operation, an increase in workers. Here we talk about when we have a quickly growing work in process inventory. So the right answer will be, in this case, a bottleneck operation. A bottleneck operation is defined as where the required capacity is greater than the available capacity. When this occurs, work in process inventory grows. Thus, work must be scheduled at a pace equal to the bottleneck work center. Question number 4. A company's available capacity can best be described as which of the following? The ability of a resource to produce a quantity of output for a particular period, the number of hours that can be used by a work center, the number of dispatched order to a work center or facility in each period, the amount of resource needed to produce output for a certain length of time. Here we will talk about the company's available capacity, not required capacity. So the right answer will be the ability of a resource to produce a quantity of output for a particular period. So this is the definition of available capacity. But the required capacity will be the amount of resource needed to produce output for a certain length of time. Question number 5. What type of product are purchased using a competitive bid with a short list of supplier with a purchase order serving as the contract? Here we will talk about a short list of supplier. Which product will purchase with a short list of supplier? Made to order items, standard product, items of small value, commodities. So the right answer will be commodities. Commodities are the product negotiated utilizing contract for future prices, like meat, metals, and wheat, and are example of commodities. Question number 6. Which system is in effect when demand on a work center is caused by the next work center and a product is not made unless signed by the next work center? Pull system, push system, ERP system, flow manufacturing. Here we talk about when the work center doesn't work unless signed by the next work center. So the right answer will be pull system. Pull system comes from a customer and sign each preceding operation. No work is performed on a product unless a sign from demand is generated. Thus, products are pulled throughout the manufacturing process. Question number 7. A traditional supply chain will have at least 3 echelons: a central organization serving as a manufacturer or provider, and what else? Upstream customer and downstream supplier, ADI with supplier and CPFR with customers, upstream supplier and downstream customer, flow of information and the flow of funds. So here we'll talk about a traditional supply chain. We'll have at least 3 echelons. The right answer will be upstream supplier and downstream customer. So at least any traditional supply chain will have a center organization serving as a manufacturer or provider, being supplied by an upstream echelon and sending product to a downstream customer echelon. Question number 8. Which of the following statement is true for critical ratio? A ratio of 0.80 means there is adequate time to complete a unit. Unit with smallest ratio should be worked first. Unit with largest ratio should be worked first. A ratio of 2.0 means two units can be built in the same time. So here we will talk about the true statement, not the false one. So the right answer will be unit with smallest ratio should be worked first. The critical ratio measures the priority of an order to the other orders at a work center. It's based on the ratio of the time remaining to work remaining. Unit with smallest ratio should be worked first. Question number 9. Regarding pricing, when does the break-even point occur? When revenue equals fixed cost, when revenue equals average cost, when revenue equals variable cost, when revenue equals total cost. When the break-even point occur when revenue equals total cost. Regarding pricing, the break-even point occur when revenue equals total cost. In a break-even point analysis, the break-even point is when the revenue line intercepts the total line. In this graph, we will notice that profit is equal to loss. Here will occur the break-even point. Question number 10. When a demand pattern changes shape over time, it's said to be which of the following? Uncontrolled, dynamic, flexible, stable. The demand pattern change shape over time, this will called dynamic. When a demand pattern change shape over time, it's said to be dynamic. Dynamic demand pattern affects the actual demands, trend, seasonality, and randomness. Note that demand pattern are stable or dynamic, not constant or controlled. Question number 11. Master planning includes what two activities? Distribution requirement planning, DRP, and forecasting, resource planning and route cut capacity planning, sales and operation planning and master scheduling, scheduling and capacity control. So the master planning include which two activity? And the right answer will be sales and operation planning and master scheduling. In the manufacturing planning and control hierarchy, master planning is part of the priority planning process and includes sales and operation planning and master scheduling. Question number 12. What is the primary reason a firm would use operation overlapping? to reduce manufacturing lead time, to reduce maintenance, to increase labor contribution, to reduce cost of purchased part. So the primary reason for the overlapping, to reduce manufacturing lead time. By allowing the next operation to be in before the whole lot is completed, lead time is reduced by the amount of overlapped operation time. Question number 13. Which of the following not a valid reason to release a material requirement planned order early? Production capacity is projected to be limited in the near term. There is potential for material shortage in the near term. Management wants to use safety lead time instead of safety stock. The warehouse is underutilized. So here we'll talk about the not valid reason to raise a material required planning order early. So the right answer will be the warehouse is underutilized. Releasing a planned order early to help fill an underutilized warehouse is not a valid reason. Doing so will put the inventory at risk and added carrying cost. So this will not be a valid reason. Question number 14. Which of the following best describe a company's strategic plan? Is contain high level plan generally stated in dollars? It contain detailed plan generally stated in dollars? It contain high level plan generally stated in unit? It contain detailed plan generally stated in units? So the strategic plan will be high level plan and stated in dollar. So the right answer will be it contain high level plan and generally stated in dollars. But the plan's objective to be provide a generally overview of the market and production need, not detailed information on individual items. Question number 15. Part of the value provided by distribution is the provide place and the time value. What is the place value? Ensuring product is available where the customer wants it. Ensure product is available when the customer wants it. Ensure the minimum use of safety stock. Ensuring there is enough space to store all the product in the same place. Here we talk about the place value. So the right answer will be ensuring product is available where the customer wants it. Place value is ensuring product is available to the customer where they want, for example, close to their home. Note that ensuring product is available when the customer wants it is called time value. When the customer wants it, not where the customer wants it. Question number 16. Which of the following is most likely an independent demand item? Manufacturing sub-assembly in a computer, service part for an elevator, subcontracted assembly for a copy machine, purchased component for a pallet sticker. So the independent demand item will be service part for an elevator. Independent demand is demand for an item that is unrelated to the demand for other item. Demand for finished good, part required for destructive testing, and service part requirement are example of independent demand. Question number 17. Which of the following identifies a reason an organization would make the decision to buy a product? Product quality will be maintained. Product requires specialized expertise. Product process are confidential. Product utilizes existing equipment. So the valid reason for the organization to buy a product will be product requires specialized expertise. An organization would decide to buy a product from another supplier if the product requires specialized expertise not available with the existing workforce. Note that other reason organization buy product from other suppliers is because it requires less capital investment, it provides competitive pricing, and it allows the organization to focus on its own area of specialization. Question number 18. Companies who embrace Kaizen and encourage ongoing identification and elimination of problem root causes are practicing which of the following? Short-term financial performance, business process improvement, continuous process improvement, business process management. So the embracing Kaizen by the organization or company will be the right answer. Continuous process improvement, CPI. Companies who embrace Kaizen and encourage ongoing identification and elimination of problem root causes are practicing continuous process improvement. Question number 19. Every aspect of the bill of material is planned by which of the following? Master production schedule, production plan, material requirement planning system, inventory plan. So the bill of material is planned which of the following? The right answer will be material requirement planning system. Every aspect of the bill of material is planned by the material requirement planning system. The bill of material is used for product definition, engineering change control, service part, planning, order entry, manufacturing, and costing. Question number 20. Have only the required inventory when needed to improve quality to zero defect, to reduce lead time by reducing setup time, queue lengths, and lot sizes, to incrementally revise the operation themselves, and to accomplish this activity at minimum cost. All of this is the definition of what? Jaiduka, one card campaign system, tech time, just in time. So the right answer will be just in time. Just in time supply chain concept originated in Japan. It says that JIT was originally developed by Toyota and became popular in the 1970s. Is defined by the APICS dictionary 75 edition as have only the required inventory when needed to improve quality to zero defect, to reduce lead time by reducing setup time, queue lengths, and lot sizes, to incrementally revise the operations themselves, and to accomplish this activity at minimum cost. Thank you for listening to our lecture 1. And see you in the next lecture.